Thanks, Louise, for joining me today. We're going to talk a little bit about the recent VE Day event that Lifelong Learning had. Obviously, the pandemic's been going on now for about 13 weeks. So how's your team been working during this?
Well, at the very start, on day one of lockdown, we redeployed to the residential services across Milton Keynes. Literally overnight, everybody just went to a new place of work the next morning. And it's been working really, really well. We've been able to achieve lots of outcomes for people that we never thought was possible, perhaps in the first few days. Yeah. And it's been really good to see what can be achieved in people's homes, in a more sort of relaxed environment, you know, and going at everybody's individual pace. It's been really good to do some more personalised work for people. Yeah. So
how did the people that you support adapt to that initial change?
It's taken a while for them to sort of, they welcomed us there straight away, but it's taken a while for them to get used to the idea that we're there to support, because obviously they go, well, you're day staff, you should be in the learning centres and the activity centres. But now they've kind of, you know, they're able to accept support from us for different things. So we've been helping people perhaps with their meal prep, with their washing, as well as with day-to-day activities. And sort of projects and things that we've been working on. So they've really sort of accepted that we've got a more diversified role. I think they're enjoying it. I think they're enjoying having that different style of support.
Yeah, so it sounds like there's been a lot of positives to take out of this moving forward then.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we've certainly learned lots about the people we support. We've learned lots about how we can work differently going forward. And I honestly think that lifelong learning is never going to look the same as it did before lockdown. And I think that's a real positive. So it's working with everybody in the team now to shape what the new normal becomes, including the people we support, because they are very much part of our team.
Yeah.
So it's about listening to their ideas and how they see it as well. So
fantastic.
Exciting, but stressful in some respects, but exciting times.
Yeah. So we're going to talk about a little bit about the VE Day events. How did that come about?
We worked out quite early on that it was really important to have some themes to connect everybody together, because with the Haddons, there's 14 individual flats and ranging from sort of one person up to four people living in those flats. So we sort of had a model that they were flat families, is what we call them, in their sort of individual households. But they were all socially distanced, even though they were on the same site and they could sort of see each other from their windows.
Yeah.
So came up with the idea, with talking to the people we support, that we really needed things to connect us, but socially distanced.
Yeah.
And VE Day was obviously on the news. There was lots of people talking about it. And people we support were understanding that normally this might have led to street parties and big countrywide events. So we decided to do something more local and celebrate within our own community.
Yeah. So how did you use co-production in the planning of the event?
From the outset, the idea was very much coming from the people we support. So it was about involving them with their creativity, with their idea planning, with their suggestions of how it might look. You know, whether that be around smart displays, we did lots of window displays, whether it was about having some music, food, because obviously food's a very important part in everything we do. And just every flat had a different feel. Some made bunting, some made posters, some supported with music.
Yep.
Everybody used their skills and talents to contribute to the overall events, which was really positive.
What, do you think there are any barriers to a successful co-production?
I think the barriers that we're facing now are a lot different to the barriers we were facing 6 months ago. Obviously, there's the very practical things about people aren't all in the same room for a start. Typically, with our shout-out meetings, we would have had posters, we would have planned events with people, and we would have quite a huge gathering, and obviously not possible. So sort of not having people in the same space has been a barrier. People's journey through lockdown has been very individual as well. Of course, anxiety, communication methods may have changed. Their ability to interact with each other has been affected because they haven't had those opportunities, that freedom to talk to people. So there's a lot of building relationships again, and about building people's confidence to find their voice again. And have that self-expression. And also, because we'll be using things like now, like with Zooming, it's taking people on a new journey of ways to communicate, which for some they'll embrace and really benefit from, and other people will feel quite frightened by.
So what do you think you and your co-producers have learned from that event?
It's really, what we've learned most of all, I think, is recognising that the pandemic has changed all our lives.
Yeah.
It's changed every single person in some shape or form, and whether that's the staff team, the managers, the people we support, the support services, everybody cannot have been escaped the impact of what's happened. And it's recognised, but also giving people the time and the space to re-establish those skills and re-establish their role within partnership working, in whatever shape or form that takes. Placing the time is going to be critical.
Yeah, it sounds like this time period has been massive in the development of your service.
I think it's been a catalyst. We were talking previously before the pandemic about making changes to the way we work, but I think it's been a catalyst to support us to embrace that and move forward at a more rapid pace than we may have done. And I just think the team has been amazing, the people we support have been amazing, and I'm so proud of the outcomes that have been achieved. The VE Day celebrations will just stay with me forever. It was just, you know, to have a socially distanced celebration, we wouldn't have thought that was possible.
No.
But it was an amazing day, and it just proves that if we all work together, anything is possible.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where,